Hey guys, my name is Matimio, and today I have some more Battlefield 4 gameplay from the beta, and I wanted to talk about the new power weapon system in the upcoming game, and more specifically, the 50 caliber rifle. Throughout today's video, you guys are gonna see me just kinda running around with this new sniper rifle, destroying people with it, and I wanted to kinda get your guys' opinion and gauge your thoughts on what you guys think of the new power weapons, or what DICE is, I think, calling them battle pickups. Because on the one hand, I like the idea of kind of having sub-objective or side objectives in there, so it's not just about only capturing key objectives, but it's also kind of going for the strategic objective where you know that some of these power weapons are going to spawn. Siege of Shanghai, for example, the top of the skyscraper spawns, I believe, two of them. You get the rocket launcher and the 50 caliber rifle. So instead of, you know, just having the central capture point in the map, you also get access to two of these amazing weapons as well. And that's really cool in concept. It's kind of something that people are going to have to fight over. The other thing is that they do a lot of damage. Like, if used correctly, especially the 50 cal, like, you can do a number on the enemy team. And it's almost to the point, especially with this weapon, where I kind of question if it's overpowered. Like, you only get 20 rounds, and you won't be able to regenerate your ammunition by going on an ammo box, or I believe that's the way it's gonna function. I know some people were saying that the USAS frag rounds, you were able to get some of your ammunition back if you had an ammo bag next to you, but I think that was a bug, so I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that that's not gonna be a function when the game launches. And also, when you die, you don't spawn back in with the weapon itself. And so this really forces you to play smart and conserve your ammunition. If you run around with like an idiot and you get yourself killed without getting a couple of kills yourself, you basically just wasted a huge opportunity to either help your team to take out maybe a helicopter or a vehicle with a rocket launcher, or to go on an amazing kill streak and kind of support your team from afar with the 50 caliber rifle. And I know some of you out there are probably thinking right now, of course they're supposed to be overpowered. Like, they're power weapons. They're meant to be amazing. As I just said, they are kind of side objectives that people are going to be fighting over. There's something that is going to be sought after so that you can get them for your team, so that you can kind of use them as an asset. They're kind of a resource, like a tank or a helicopter, where if used correctly, it can swing the battle into your favor. And I understand that, and I would agree that would be the case for all of the power weapons except for the 50 caliber rifle, because at least in my opinion, it is a step above in power compared to every weapon in the game. And I think what it just really comes down to is that it just has a little bit too much ammunition. You start off with 20 rounds, and if you're good with it, you become amazing with the high-powered rifles in this game, that's potentially 20 dead enemies. If you're not aware, this weapon, if you hit them anywhere in their body, you hit them in the toe, their shin, they're gonna drop, and it's a one-shot kill at all ranges. So it doesn't matter the distance, it doesn't matter where you hit them. You hit them with this rifle, they're gonna drop dead. And so if you get really good with them, and there are gonna be people out there that are gonna become amazing with this weapon, they could potentially go on a 20 kill streak with absolutely no problem. But don't get me wrong, I have no problem with the actual game mechanic. I think it's okay that you're able to get a one-shot kill at all ranges no matter where you hit them. My problem is that it seems like that it just has a little bit too much ammunition. If you guys have used the rocket launcher or the grenade launcher, you can maybe take out one helicopter, one tank, you can maybe get a couple of grenade kills on the enemy team, but that's about it. Like, if you do really well, maybe you can go on a little bit more of a kill streak with it, but then you're back to using your primary weapon. But that's not really the case with the 50 cal. Like, if you're good, as I said, you can conserve your ammunition, you can kill a ridiculous amount of people and really support your team. And so I would think to kind of put it more in line with all of the other battle pickups is to reduce its ammo count. Maybe drop it down to like 15. You don't need to go too crazy. You don't need to go down to 10 because there still needs to be good. But as it stands right now, I think it just has a little bit too much firepower. But I would like to know what you guys think. I mean, this is what betas are for, is so that we can give our ideas and we can give our suggestions, and so that when the game launches, things can be a little bit more balanced. So let me know down below in the comment section. But that is about it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed the Battlefield 4 gameplay in the background. I know you guys are probably sick of seeing Siege of Shanghai gameplay. I know I kind of am as well, and I cannot wait until the game launches. I'm even having a hard time going back to like Battlefield 3, for example. Like, I'm even playing like Battlefield 2. I actually yesterday played Battlefield 19 42, so I may post some gameplay of that. But yeah, guys, until tomorrow, have a good one and take it easy.